Now, Alexandra Burke is back. 4 years after her X Factor success, the pop soul princess remains at the top. Oh, here I go. Trip-chopping way down low. You thought so this, wind them to this. Don't leave me song without you. See us moving like some dancing all night long. When we're together, baby, I'm feeling no way. You got me all night long. I said the bad boys are always catching my eye.
And she's here now. Welcome.
Welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
Because
for
you see
me.
All that, and then there was this gap, this break.
Yes. And no one realises it was like a year and a half I've been out of it.
I can't believe it was a year and a half.
Yeah.
So why?
Well, I've had my head down, literally recording my album.
Yeah.
I'm the executive producer of this album, so I really wanted to take my time and really focus. And I've learned a lot about myself in the past year and a half that
what
I really
learned?
Wanted. Oh, I've just learned way too much.
About bad
life
things.
In general. Well, just growing up, I guess, wanting to, you know, find myself a little bit more and concentrate and really focus. Not that I wasn't before, but you get to a point in life where you're like, okay, what do I want to talk about in my music now? What direction do I want to go in?
Yeah.
And obviously the move from Psycho to RCA was a big change for me as well.
Yeah, how did that affect you? Because obviously I don't know how much Simon still sort of has
he's not that involved as much anymore, but he does, you know, he will always call if I need him. He's always still there, and that's what I really respect and appreciate about him. Mm. But the move was wasn't tough, it was just a challenge.
Does it make coming back quite nerve-wracking?
Yeah, oh my God, anything I do, whether it be doing stuff for charity or promoting or anything, I always get really nervous. I'm shaking right now speaking to you guys. Because, I don't know, I just care about it so much that I just get really nervous.
Well, let's talk about the single, because the single is a bit of a change of direction.
Yes.
A completely different sound, actually.
Yes, yeah, it is. But the second album isn't this Ibiza dance kind of trance thing. It's, I mean, if you're going to have Eric Murillo on the track, it's going to sound very much like it's in Ibiza and stuff, because that's what he's about. He's a legend. So it's a real honour to have him on the first track. But, you know, the second album is very heavily influenced by the 90s kind of era. Robin S, Soul to Soul, Donna Summer.
You haven't got a date for the release yet?
No date yet.
Or a name?
No name yet.
Ah.
But that will be decided this week.
Brilliant. Oh, really?
It shall,
oh, you've
yes.
got big decisions tonight, then.
Yeah, yeah.
And the song Elephant is about... is it based on a relationship?
It's, yeah, it's based on... I was dating a guy last year, and I never heard of that saying, there's an elephant in the room, ever in my life, until I'd done this writing camp for the album. And we were going through a situation, no one was talking about it, so clearly there was an elephant in the room, and it can relate to anyone, mothers, daughters, sons and fathers. It's, so anyone that hears it, I'm hoping that you can relate to it in something in your life or something you're going through now.
Does anyone that date you just go, oh, I could end up in a song?
No, I hope not.
Say that to me.
No,
I just wonder, because
it's funny though, because I'm still friends with the guy I was seeing last year,
and he actually said,
"Oh God, I had to tell him because he knew it was about him." So I was like, "Yeah, by the way, my new single's kind of about you," and he was like, "Oh."
And you said,
great.
"It's about the elephant in a room," and he went,
yeah.
"Thanks very much."
Yeah, there we go.
So you go for the older guy, don't you?
I'm more drawn
are
to
you?
The older guy.
I was looking up because you saw you in the papers with Jermaine Defoe, and I looked up his age today, and he's 30. The older guy.
He's 29.
Is he?
Yeah. Oh, there you go. But you're younger than people think you are. That's why.
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 23 now.
So you're because you think of you as being much older. I don't know if it's the way you carry yourself or the way you are. But
a lot of people tell me that. I remember when I first met Simon when I was 16, and he goes to me, "You look like a 25, love," and I was like, "Wow."